Hello, welcome to McMaster's Demystifying Medicine series. Today, we'll be demystifying drugs for depression. First, we'll discuss what depression is, the signs, symptoms, and risk factors associated with it. Then we'll dive into the three common classes of antidepressant medications, TCAs, SSRIs, and SNRIs, and discuss some examples, how they work, their side effects, and who should avoid them. Depression is a common but serious mood disorder that can impact the way you think, feel, and handle daily activities. It ranges from mild to severe and is typically characterized by a persistent sad, anxious, or empty mood, feelings of hopelessness, helplessness, and worthlessness, reduced pleasure or interest in hobbies and activities, fatigue and decreased energy, difficulty sleeping, appetite changes, and in more severe cases, thoughts of death or suicide. Depression is a complex disorder that arises from an interaction of genetic, biological, psychological, and environmental factors. Some risk factors for depression include a personal or family history of depression, major life changes, trauma or stress, and even certain physical illnesses and medications. Depression can often be managed and treated. Treatment usually involves psychotherapy or medication, or a combination of both. While there are many different antidepressants on the market, certain drug classes are more common. These include tricyclic antidepressants, or TCAs, selective serotonin reuptake inhibitors, or SSRIs, and selective serotonin noradrenaline reuptake inhibitors, also known as SNRIs. Tricyclic antidepressants are a class of medications that were first released in 1959 for major depressive disorder, or MDD. Today, TCAs are approved by the Food and Drug Administration, or FDA, to treat various illnesses, particularly for the management of MDD. TCAs impact the serotonin and norepinephrine neurotransmitter pathways. Neurotransmitters are chemical messengers that carry signals between nerve cells, known as neurons, in the nervous system. After carrying a signal, neurotransmitters are reabsorbed by the neurons, a process called reuptake. Serotonin and norepinephrine are neurotransmitters responsible for many bodily functions, including mood and emotional regulation, attention, learning, and memory. People with depression are believed to have lower levels of serotonin and norepinephrine in the brain. TCAs work to fix that by blocking the reuptake of serotonin and norepinephrine by neurons, increasing concentrations of these neurotransmitters, which likely contributes to TCA's antidepressant effect. TCAs are available in the form of oral tablets, capsules, and solutions. The exact dosages for each TCA type vary, however, because TCAs have a high risk of adverse effects, so initial dosing is low and is gradually increased based on the level of response. It may take up to 4 weeks to see an improvement in depression symptoms. Some examples of drugs that fall under the TCA drug class include amoxapine, doxepine, imipramine, protriptyline, and trimipramine. While TCAs are effective, they've generally been replaced by antidepressants that cause fewer side effects. Some common side effects of TCAs include drowsiness, slight blurring of vision, weight gain, dizziness, constipation, and dry mouth. TCAs may also increase the risk of cardiovascular complications, seizures in epileptic patients, suicidal ideation in those under 24 years of age, and birth defects in pregnant patients, so they must be prescribed after a thorough examination of an individual's health history. Despite all these side effects, TCAs may still be a good option for certain people as they relieve depression when other treatments have failed. Selective serotonin reuptake inhibitors are the most commonly prescribed antidepressants. They are often used as first-line prescription for moderate to severe depression due to their safety and efficacy. SSRIs are similar to TCAs, however, SSRIs treat depression by only increasing concentrations of serotonin in the brain, hence the selective serotonin in its name. The goal of an SSRI is to inhibit the reuptake of serotonin into neurons, which makes more serotonin available to the brain and to improve the transmission of messages between neurons. It may take up to 6 weeks to see improvements in depression symptoms. SSRIs are usually taken as tablets, but are also available in capsule or liquid solution forms. Some SSRIs approved by the FDA to treat depression include citalopram, escitalopram, fluoxetine, paroxetine, and sertraline. SSRIs aren't suitable for everyone. They're not usually recommended if you're pregnant, breastfeeding, or under the age of 18, because there's an increased risk of serious side effects. Common side effects include feeling agitated, diarrhea or constipation, loss of appetite, dizziness, and dry mouth. SSRIs also need to be used with caution if you have certain underlying health problems like diabetes, epilepsy, and kidney disease. Selective serotonin noradrenaline reuptake inhibitors are another class of drugs that can be used to treat depression. They were developed to be more effective than SSRIs, but there is little evidence showing whether this is actually the case. Much like TCAs, SNRIs work to inhibit the reuptake of serotonin and norepinephrine. So, they increase the availability of both serotonin and norepinephrine in the brain to improve depression symptoms. Interestingly, SNRIs remain in the body for shorter periods of time compared to TCAs and SSRIs, so they have faster effects on the body. That said, they may take up to 8 weeks to improve depression symptoms. SNRIs are available in tablet and capsule form. The side effects of SNRIs are similar to those of SSRIs. These drugs can also bring about nausea, anxiety, and panic attacks. SNRIs may not be suitable for people with heart health issues, a history of panic, or issues with hyperactivity, as the medication may exacerbate these situations. Some major SNRIs approved by the FDA include venlafaxine, duloxetine, desvenlafaxine, milnacipran, and levomilnacipran. There are a lot of different medications available for treating depression. It is difficult to predict how well a particular medication will help an individual. Doctors often prescribe a drug that they consider to be effective and relatively well tolerated. If the prescribed drug does not work, it's possible to switch to a different medication. Sometimes, you may have to try a number of different antidepressants before you find one that works. Studies show that the benefit generally depends on the severity of the depression. The more severe the depression, the greater the benefits will be. Studies involving adults with moderate or severe depression have shown the following. About 30% of individuals who took a placebo noticed an improvement in their symptoms. In comparison, about 50% of individuals who took an antidepressant noticed an improvement in their symptoms. Studies have also shown that taking commonly used antidepressants such as TCAs, SSRIs, or SNRIs can lower the risk of relapses, but can't completely prevent them. 50% of those who took a placebo relapse after 1 to 2 years, while 23% of those who took an antidepressant relapse after 1 to 2 years. Here is a table to summarize and compare everything we have just learned about TCAs, SSRIs, and SNRIs. As a disclaimer, the information presented in this video is for educational purposes only. Please consult with a doctor before taking any prescribed medication. Thanks for joining us on McMaster Demystifying Medicine. If you enjoyed this video, don't forget to subscribe so you don't miss out on any new content.